Oi mate, it looks like our systems are down. Have you checked the dashboard?
I have, but the metrics are blank.
Fair dinkum, have you checked the logs?
I have, but the logs are blank.
Struth, mate. We host this one on Google Cloud, right? Anything weird on there?
Yeah, the private cloud we set up last year.
It's gone. Crikey.
Let's rewind 1 year to see exactly how we got to this situation. On May 1st, 2023, the Google Cloud VMware Engine, or GCVE team, was enjoying their free team massage when they received a ticket from one of their customers in Australia, UniSuper. This is an industry superannuation fund which handles workplace pensions and currently manages around $135 billion Australian dollars for over 600,000 Australians. Employers in Australia are required to contribute 11.5% on top of your wage to a super account provided by funds like UniSuper, which you can then withdraw from in retirement. As an American, this appears to function similarly to the 401k we have here. Anyways, UniSuper builds their software on top of VMware, which is a platform that offers solutions for building on-premises cloud environments. If you want all the cool cloud features like the ability to spin up virtual machines at will, auto-scale, load balance, failover, provision storage, databases, containers, and have all of this stuff seamlessly integrated together, but you don't want to deal with big cloud, you can get your own hardware and run private cloud software like VMware, CloudStack, or OpenStack on top of it to get the same experience. But eventually you find out that big cloud might actually be pretty good, and some of your friends have even gone all in on big cloud. So you spin the wheel to decide which one to use, and migrate some stuff onto there. However, you don't want to leave behind all the VMware tooling that you've gotten used to. Fortunately, Big Cloud has already considered your use case. With Google Cloud's VMware Engine, you can migrate your VMware-based applications to Google Cloud without changes to your apps, tools, or processes. Now you can sit back and relax as you hand your infrastructure over for a small fee of $5.11 per hour over 3 years. But then you discover that the private cloud you need for your service has special capacity requirements which cannot be provisioned using the publicly available Google Cloud interface, so you contact Google to see what they can do. This is what UniSuper did, and Google's VMware Engine team had just received their request. The engineers reviewed the ticket and decided that they could move forward by deploying this special cloud using an internal tool that can deploy VMware Engine clouds for customers. They filled in the parameters for account, region, hardware specs, and hopefully ran it by a second engineer prior to executing it as part of their internal control protocols. Everything looked good, and they ran the command. UniSuper then saw that everything was provisioned correctly and everyone was happy. For now. Fast forward 1 year later, on May 1st, 2024, the UniSuper devs noticed that one of their key services stopped responding, and that the entire service and the cloud in which it was hosted seemed to no longer exist. This was pretty strange, since the audit logs did not show any engineers deleting it, and private clouds usually don't delete themselves. In any case, whether or not it was their fault, they had to get to the bottom of this as soon as possible. The site was going to be completely inoperational until this was fixed, not to mention the entire stack of both compute capacity and databases were deleted, and losing financial data for over $100 billion worth of holdings could end up being pretty bad. So the engineers immediately reached out to Google asking what was going on, and the Googlers checked their internal API logs. Filtering for UniSuper's cloud, they saw that it was deleted automatically due to its 1 year fixed term expiring. This was unusual since this kind of auto-deletion behavior was not possible to achieve in a typical customer-created cloud. Upon further investigation, they found out that exactly 1 year ago on this day, the UniSuper cloud was created manually by Google engineers using an internal tool. Everything was correct except it was missing a crucial parameter. The postmortem didn't actually specify what this missing parameter was, but because it was missing, the private cloud was created with the default behavior of automatically deleting itself after 1 year. So restoring the application components was going to be fairly straightforward. They simply had to reprovision the infrastructure and deploy the code, all with existing tooling. However, getting all the data back was going to require a lot of manual work and some novel automation coded up. In some circumstances, data can be restored using a replica or production stack in a different availability zone that wasn't subject to erasure, However, this was not possible here since their entire cloud, which spanned both of their zones holding all of their production data, was deleted. They were saved, however, because they backed up their data. Not only did they have backups in Google Cloud Storage, which was a separate service unrelated to the deleted cloud, but they also had backups with a different provider. As the two companies worked together to get the service back up and running, the customers began complaining. This was reasonable as they could no longer access or view their funds, and there was also fear regarding it being a potential cyber attack. Little did they know, UniSuper just had their application deleted by a third party and they could literally do nothing about it. They reassured their users by releasing a statement saying there was an issue originating from one of their third-party service providers and that it wasn't a malicious attack. Then the statement was updated to reveal the name of the service provider as Google Cloud, as well as assigning the blame to them. Some were skeptical and believed UniSuper may have been scapegoating their cloud provider for their own operational issues. However, all doubts ceased on May 8th when the Google Cloud CEO confirmed that it was their fault. Around the same time, users began to be able to log into UniSuper and view their mostly up-to-date balances. Finally, by May 15th, 2 weeks after the accidental deletion, everything was back up and running again. So what are the big learnings here? For Google, the internal tool they are describing is very mysterious. Only those involved would know why the default behavior was for clouds to automatically delete themselves. Maybe the tool was originally for internal testing purposes only, and the automated deletion was to allow the inevitable pile-up of test clouds to be cleaned up. Then, upon being polished up for production use, this sketchy behavior was overlooked. It's also unusual that no one else was affected first, given Google VMware Engine was released in May 2020, so it had been operating for 3 years by the time the bad command was run. Perhaps UniSuper simply had a super unique use case. But it's possible there were other ticking time bomb clouds that simply hadn't gone off yet. Google says they scrubbed and reviewed the database, but they were ambiguous as to whether or not they discovered any other cases. For UniSuper, they're probably backing up the backups of their backups now. It is a harsh reality that your stuff can be deleted at any moment due to someone else's operational error, but that's why we have backups. A common strategy is to follow the 3-2-1 rule of 3 copies on 2 types of media with 1 off-site. There isn't much else they could have done here. They can switch cloud providers or go back to on-prem, but those are complex decisions that have their own downsides and not necessarily a major learning. It is also unknown how significant the deleted cloud was. UniSuper had most likely completed their cloud migration to GCP at this point, but it is unknown whether the deleted VPC contained their entire company or just a key service. In the end, this is a good lesson for anyone to learn regarding backups. It's like insurance, seemingly useless most of the time and a hassle, but when the 1-in-a-million chance disaster strikes, you better have it ready.
May 2020, GCVE took flight. Seamless VMware migration to the cloud was in sight. They had dashboards, metrics, operational tools. Got it all figured out. Google devs ain't fools. Then $1 billion UniSuper comes around. Needs a VMware cloud, but the specs weren't found. So they went and asked Google Ops to spin that thing up. Except there was a slight catch. It would soon blow up. Engineers scrambled, their logs blank as the dawn. Their vital infrastructure was just suddenly gone. It was truly an unprecedented black swan event. There was nothing UniSuper could do to prevent.
Backups are a lifeline and backups we trust. When prod is deleted, backups are a must. 3 copies, 2 media, 1 off-site. No backups, I'm leaving till you make it right.